What's good, everybody? Game Paradox here, and welcome back to another Manga Haul. Yeah, Manga Haul. I was thinking this was a Manga Haul Manga Collection video, but welcome back to another Manga Haul video. Today, we got the January of 2021 Manga Haul, and my last Manga Haul was in October of 2020, but if you guys know, I think I mentioned in that video that I took a break from buying manga, and I got a shit ton of manga over the holiday sales, because you know Right Stuff has a bunch of sales during the holidays, so you know I had to cop, and trust me, we got a lot of manga volumes. So I'm not gonna waste any time. If you guys want to see more manga haul videos, hit the up for like, comment, subscribe, do all that, and let's get into the pickups. First off, we have a ton of Naruto. As you guys know, as I said before, Naruto is one of my favorite series of all time for manga / anime, and I want to collect the entire series. We're starting off with part one. I almost have every volume of part one. I just need a couple of more. I'm nowhere close. I'm at the halfway point, I would say. Naruto's one of my favorite series, all-time favorite. Naruto's like my favorite MC. I love him. I love the series. And I actually wanted to reread Naruto. That's another big reason why I'm getting a lot of these volumes, because I haven't seen Naruto since I was younger. I definitely want to continue Naruto. So we have volumes 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, and then we're gonna do a big jump. We're gonna go straight to Shippuden. We got volume 28, 29, 30, and then finally 31. But as I just said, Naruto, I love Naruto, all-time favorite. And I'm glad to have it in my collection, and hopefully we can finish up the collection soon. Hey, next up on my list, we have another one of my favorite series, if not probably my favorite series right now. Currently, we have Full Metal Alchemist. We got a decent amount of Full Metal Alchemist volumes. Full Metal Alchemist, like I said before, is one of my favorite series of all time, if not my favorite series of all time. I really swap around a lot, like which is my favorite series of all time around. Is not, but most of the time it is Full Metal. It's between Full Metal, Naruto, One Piece, those three. Those are my big three. But I really love the series a lot, and I definitely need the manga, because if you don't know, the manga is a bit different from the anime. I think just how it starts and somewhere around the middle, it's a little bit different, but most of it's still the same. And I've been wanting to rewatch Full Metal, but I was like, I'm getting all the manga files, might as well reread it this time, see how it's different in the manga. And there's only 22 volumes, so 27 volumes. So I'm getting closer to catching up. But we have volumes 4, 5, 6, 7, and finally numero 8. These are all the Full Metal covers. And something else I have to say, these volume covers are really sick. I really like these covers. And I think my favorite one out of this bunch is probably this cover. But also I really like the cover for volume 6. I don't know, it's really fire. I like these covers a lot. Right, next up in my collection, we have probably the most random volume and series. I don't even know if I'm going to fully collect this series, but I have the most random volume in here, and that would be Shokugeki no Soma. Now, I recently watched Food Wars, like around the time I was ordering all this manga, so around the Christmas Thanksgiving season, and I enjoyed the first season enough to get the manga. And if you don't know, the artist for Food Wars is like really, really good. Like you see this cover, and like he draws the second volume cover I like a lot more than the first volume cover, but this one's really good. And like just in general, his art is like really, really good. I really enjoy it. So I'll just have the first volume in my collection, but I do hear that later on towards the series, like towards the 5th, 4th season, it does fall off in quality a lot. So but I haven't watched anything past season 1 of Food Wars. So next up, we have a series that I've been waiting to finally complete and for my collection for a very long time, and we were finally able to do it, and I'm so happy because this is one of my favorite manga of all time, and it just ended recently, and that would be We Never Learn Bokuben. Let's go. I finally got the rest of the volumes I needed to complete this series. This is actually my first completed series in my manga collection. I'm glad it can be this one, something I like. All I needed was volumes, as you can see, 3, 4, you see, I needed these volumes, and I finally purchased all of them on Right Stuff. Luckily for me, They just came back in stock as soon as I placed my order, so I was able to cop all of them, and now I have the entire series so far that's released in the West of We Never Learn Bogeyman. And this series ended recently, so I'm gonna need y'all to read this, right? This series is about, well, if you ever seen the Quincentussal Quintuplets, that name always gets me, or Gotoban, I think that's the Japanese name, but the Quincentussal Quintuplets, if you've seen that series, imagine that. Imagine the Quincentussal Quintuplets, but it's not as story-driven in the beginning, I would say so, at least I think so, I don't really remember. But anyway, this is about a student named Naoyuki. He's not rich or anything, but he goes to school and he tries really hard, and he's like one of the smartest kids in the school. And he has to tutor these three girls. One of them is an athlete. She isn't really good at any subject. Another one is a student that's really good at English, but is really bad at math. And then the other one is a student who's really good at math, but really bad at English. So you can see where this is going. So they all tutor him, and they all start to fall for him, start catching feelings for him. And it's a harem, slice of life, rom-com series. It's probably like one of the funniest series. This is the best. See, every genre this falls under, slice of life, rom-com, harem, all that, this is the best in. I'm just going to say, it's the best in it. It's my favorite, at least. And something else that's great about this, I think this is the only series that I've seen that's done this, at least. Every girl, like there's like five girls, every girl has their own route. So, and there's actually another route, a sixth route, where he doesn't get with any of them. So if you don't like any of them, he doesn't get with them. If you like one girl, guess what? He gets with him. You get your whole arc just for that girl. You like another one, she gets a whole arc as well. Every single person wins who reads this manga. You literally cannot be disappointed in the ending with this manga. So yeah, you guys definitely need to cop this, get into this series. And also the covers are fire. Just look at this. We have volumes 3, 4, 9, 10, 12. Finally, the last volume that is out in the West right now, volume 13. And this cover, Asumi. One of my favorites right here. Awesome. But that's all that We Never Learned, and I'm glad I have finally completed this series. Now, next up, we have another one of my favorite series going on right now, and I'm actually almost caught up with this series as well, and that would be My Hero Academia. So yeah, we got a hefty amount of My Hero Academia volumes. See, sadly, volume 2 wasn't in stock, so I can't get volume 2 yet, which really annoys me, so I had to go somewhere else to get volume 2. But it's whatever. And also, this is the latest volume of My Hero Academia. Now, the funny story of this getting this volume for me is I bought this volume thinking it was already out, but it didn't come out yet. But it came out like a few days after I already placed my order. So at first I thought, oh, this volume will just come out, volume 26 will just come out when it comes out. But it came out a few days later. So I think they waited on my order a little bit for this to come out and then shipped it out. That's why it took longer than expected, because I ordered this on Christmas and I'm now just getting it almost a whole month later. But I'm not too mad at them. It's the holiday season. No, I'm not really complaining. By the way, don't know if I said this, I get all my manga and write stuff. But I really love My Hero Academia. Before, I wasn't super hot on My Hero. Like I always enjoyed it, but I wasn't like super interested into it. Until somewhat recently when I read the manga and saw everything that's going on, I'm like, wow, this is actually like really good. But the latest few chapters have kind of been iffy. I want to see where Horikoshi is going in this, with this direction, before I say anything about it. But that's My Hero Academia, and I'm almost caught up. Actually, there are more volumes that I got that I wasn't worth writing stuff. One second. I only need a few more volumes until I'm completely caught up with this series. It's less than 10, so we're almost caught up with this series, so let's just go through all the volumes real quick. We have volumes 3, 4, 5. I actually got to grab a couple more, but that's volume 5, 6, 7, and this cover is really fire. I really like this cover, but this is volume 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. We're gonna do a big run to volume 18, 19, and finally the latest volume, volume 26. So on a 26 volume of My Hero, almost at 30 volumes. But these volumes, I really like these volume covers as well, especially this one. I really like the color. It's just the colors and the characters, you know. It's lit in Jiro, you're the low-key best girl now, but it's whatever. Yeah, I really enjoy My Hero Academia. And if you guys were iffy about My Hero before, I know the fandom is a real pain to get into. But yeah, if you didn't enjoy My Hero before, I'd say give it another chance. It does get really good. It's really good right now. And yeah, that's My Hero. Now, next up, these are just going to be some filler manga before we get to the last big chunk of manga that I got. First off, we have volume one of Attack on Titan. Attack on Titan is also one of my favorite series of all time, and I'm surprised I didn't have the manga of this before. But just recently, season four started like last month, and the past two episodes of Attack on Titan have been insane. Like some of the biggest parts in the series. So I'm like, you know what? I'm not going to read the manga just yet. I'm gonna wait till this season finishes, and then I may read the manga. But yeah, volume one of Attack on Titan. The manga actually is a bit different from the anime, which I was actually surprised. But I thought the anime was perfect. Attack on Titan volume one. I'll probably collect the series, but not anytime soon. I just wanted the first volume just so I say I can have it, and it looks really, really nice. Next we have Boruto. You guys already know why I'm reading Boruto. If just in case Naruto does end up passing, I want to be able to read the manga. I don't think this is in my last manga haul. Oh, I actually spoiled the next volume. But I don't know if Naruto does die, I want to be able to read it and experience it. And you know, I'm genuinely interested in Boruto as well. I don't think this was in my last video. It definitely wasn't. I don't think it was, at least. But that's Boruto Volume 6. Now, next up, we have Volume 2 of the Persona 5 manga. Yeah, as you can see right here. As you can see, it looks right here. Right here, I am a Persona 5 stan. Persona 5 is my favorite game of all time. So I was like, and the manga's coming out. And the manga, you know, the covers, the art's interesting enough. So I decided to cop it. You know, look at An in the back, baby girl. So, Persona 5 Volume 2. Oh yeah, if you want to get into Persona, do not read the manga or watch the animes of it. Just play the games. Just trust me, just play the games. Last, we have Volume 4 of Dead Man Wonderland. Dead Man Wonderland is a series that I'm trying to get into. I've been slowly reading it, but I've been trying to read it. So like next haul, I might just cop the rest of the volumes, because there's only 13 volumes. And right now I'm on Volume 4. I haven't read this volume yet, but the first three volumes were really good. So I bet I'll just enjoy it just as much. Same with the rest of the series. All right, we are in the end game of this manga haul video, and you know, this next volume is a brand new series that I want to try to start collecting and try to start reading, along with another series made by the same author as well, and that would be Soul Eater. Soul Eater is a series that I've always known of but never really got into. And then when I found out this Fire Force was created, the author of Fire Force also created Soul Eater, I'm like, oh, now I'm super interested because I like Fire Force. But I'm gonna try to start reading Soul Eater. I know it has like 30-ish volumes. I'm like, yeah, fuck it, dude, let's just start reading Soul Eater. So I only caught volume one because only volume one was in stock at the time, and I wasn't gonna get like volume three or something. Like, where else are we, volume three? But then, yeah, Soul Eater volume one, characters look cool enough that I think this is Black Star, right? Or is it Death the Kid? I don't know. I only know Maka, Death the Kid, and then Black Star, and I know the opening of Soul Eater. That's all I know about this. It's literally nothing else. Also, I know the anime didn't have the same ending as the manga. That's all I know about the series. But looking forward to getting into Soul Eater. And let's go into the last big chunk of the video. Ooh, this is a lot of volumes. Yeah, this is gonna be the last. These are the last chunk of volumes I got from. These are the last chunk of volumes I got from Right Stuff. And these volumes are. We got a lot of Fire Force. I can't even hold it with one hand. I can barely hold it with one hand. Actually, I can't at all. I need two. But a lot of Fire Force. Basically, I got volume 4 to 15. Of Fire Force. Basically, you're wondering, like, Isaiah, how much did you spend on this? And how did you get so many volumes of Fire Force? First off, don't ask how much I spent on this. Too much. Second off, Right Stuff does this cool sale during the holidays, or doing sales in general, where you'll do this thing where you can get three volumes for the price of one or two. So, Fire Force were one of the many series that were doing that, along with Black Clover. I was thinking about getting Black Clover, but I was like, nah. But Fire Force was doing this, and as you guys know, I went to read the Fire Force manga and get caught up with it, and this was the perfect time. So I'm like, all right, bet I'm gonna cop like half the volumes. But I didn't get caught up to it. There's still, I need to get volume 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, and I think 21 just released, or it's coming out next month in the West. So I still need to get like 5 more volumes till I'm completely caught up with the English releases at least. But yeah, Fire Force is another series like My Hero that I was really iffy on. It came out summer of 2019, the anime at least, and I watched it and I enjoyed the first season, the second half not so much. I'm like, oh yeah, Fire Force, whatever, not something I want to get the manga though. But then the second season dropped and I'm like, hey yo, this shit, like, no pun intended, this shit's gas, this shit's fire, I have to read it. And I heard though it's actually ending soon anyway, so I'm like, yeah, I'm definitely gonna have to cop all of this. And Right Stuff came with the sales at the perfect time. Shout out to Right Stuff. And yeah, I also really enjoy, I actually really enjoy the art for both this series and Soul Eater as well. So yeah, I'm glad to finally have all of these in my collection. But yeah, I guess we should go real quick with this. So we have volume. This is going to be a lot. Stay tight. Actually, before I talk about that, I want to talk about like why the hell this series gets hate for the fan service. I don't really understand that, because it's like it's a shonen manga. Like everything's gonna have fans. It's just really weird. But I mean, if you're one of those people that don't like this series because of the fan service, first off, get over it, man. You probably like your favorite series is probably like High School of the Dead or some shit. You know, it's shonen. Like it's everywhere. You can't escape it. I guess with the series, you could say it's a little bit more extra, but it's really not that bad. It's only in the first beginning, I would say. But yeah, we have volumes 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and finally volume 15. And like I said before, this isn't every single volume I can get right now, but I'm pretty close to being caught up with it. And yeah, I'm excited to see where the manga goes. But yeah, overall, that is my biggest manga haul yet and probably ever. I don't think I'm ever going to spend that much amount of manga again. I'm gonna get them slowly, like how I've been doing, and like, you know, these videos will be released like every couple of months. You know, you had to wait what, 3 months for this one after the October one? 2-3 months? Yeah, that's going to be it for this video. I hope you all enjoyed. Be sure to comment, like, subscribe, do all that. If you want to see more manga haul videos, I know the last one did pretty well for my channel at least, so I just want to thank you guys for that. And yeah, I'll be seeing you next time. Peace.